Tēnā koutou katoa. I'm Alana King and I teach Year 4 and 5 children at Appleby School, near Nelson. Appleby's a rural 5-teacher school, about 10 minutes drive from the wine-growing countryside around Richmond. In 2006, our school was fortunate enough to be able to finance a pod of 12 Apple laptops that came in a cowl, computers on wheels, that we were able to trolley around the classrooms on a shared basis. This year, the pod was broken up between classes throughout the morning to allow support for reading and writing and maths programs, and available as a unit for the whole class instruction in the afternoons. The cow is supported by wireless access through our Airport Extreme base station, and we all have 8 wired access plugs in each classroom. All classrooms have access to our library collection catalogue through the desktop network to the iMac. Our internet access is filtered, but our watchdog is happy to unblock any sites we ask within a couple of days. In late 2005, I attended a workshop on online learning environments with Mark Treadwell, who intrigued me by taking a photo of us and putting it on the internet while we were in quick discussion groups. This was my first experience with blogging. He said it was easy and that he used Blogger. I went home and made myself a personal blog, which I practiced over a month or so, and after that felt confident enough to use it with children. At first I did the writing and the taking of photos for the class blog, but as we got better at it, the children took over. All classes at Appleby School now have a blog, and all the school blogs linked together, with children encouraged to contribute to each other's blogs through commenting. In my class each week, we have a new pair of blogging monitors, whose job it is to record at least one post per week. But we often blog much more than that, as interesting things happen, and I contribute to class notices and the like as a means of communicating with parents. From the blog, we have links to a myriad of Web 2 tools. The most useful are the clock, which lets us see what the time is in our collaborating classrooms in Wales and New York. We have a Delicious account, which lets us access websites without having to worry about typing in the URLs incorrectly. It is also a good way of archiving sites that children may use less frequently, but are still very useful. We have a site counter and a cluster map. Children get very excited when they see proof of just how many people are looking at our blog and where those people live globally. We have also just started up using Dave Warlick's Class Blogmeister blog as a reflective tool where all the children are able to post to their own blog at the same time and not be overly concerned about correct grammar or spelling or punctuation as it would be in a more open published blog like our Class Showcase blogger. Blogmeister lends itself so well as a reflective journal for children to record their thinking, and that is where we're heading with it when children get more confident in using it. After this blogging, I felt more confident with writing on the web, and the iWeb came out as an Apple web authoring tool. It was so much easier and simpler than other methods, so I was able to reconstruct the school website to be more interactive, and thought I might have a go at podcasting because Point England School in Auckland had got an international award for their podcast and they were on TV, so I knew someone else was podcasting in New Zealand. Our ICT cluster financed a flight for myself and a local principal for a day trip to the Big Smoke. Point England's podcasting was inspirational and I was hooked. Their podcasts are focused on improving literacy skills, but ours are more generalist, focused on the happenings and learning in our classroom. If we can't think of something to podcast about, we do a book review. After considerable struggle, I managed to get our podcast subscribable through iTunes. Every week, I have 3 monitors who podcast, one to concentrate on the technical side and the other 2 to do the talking. The children are getting better at the technical side of things, and I'm fortunate enough to have a couple who really like GarageBand, our podcasting application that is, and can do the business pretty much without much input from me. I just do the tidying up at the end. I believe every child should have the opportunity to have a go, so the quality of our podcasting fluctuates a bit, but hey, we're all learners here. Sometimes we do whole class podcasts, so everyone gets a go. Through commenting on our tagged podcast, we made a number of links around the globe. Significantly with Paul Harrington's class in the valleys of South Wales. They sent us a small geocaching bear, Tiny Ted, and we sent them a cuddly kiwi that we share the travels with via the blog. A natural follow-on from this contact has been a number of Skype conversations, firstly with a local school and then further afield to Wales, and Beth Sullivan's class in Bimington School near New York. Again, to start with, I found one other person to Skype with and practice personally until I got the hang of it. In order to share our photos of our geocaching, I started a Flickr account and have recently begun tagging photos and blog posts, having been showed the simplicity of using RSS and the use of blog lines to aggregate the blogs that I follow. We have a class digital camera that I allow children to take home and take photos with of specific subjects. The child then posts it to our class blog. A couple of children have recently started up their own blogs, which I'm really proud of, and these are linked from our class blog as well. That's about it, really. There are challenges in using web-based educational technologies in the classroom, but the rewards are great in the way of communication and engagement from students. These tools weren't all started at once, and as Cheryl said, you have to own something before you give it away. I think the answer is to become more comfortable with the tools for yourself and introduce them in a meaningful context, and you're sure to succeed.